In this illustration, we'll study about connecting isolated spheres, where we are given that two isolated metal spheres of radii r and 2r are charged such that both have equal charge density sigma coulomb per meter square. And it is given that the spheres are located far away from each other. And if the two spheres are connected by a wire, we are required to find the final charge density on the bigger sphere. So here we can draw a situation like here we are given that there is a sphere of radius r. There is another sphere which is of radius 2r. And if we talk about the charges, they are such that the surface charge densities are equal. So we can write if sigma is the surface charge density, charge on first sphere, which is the smaller one, can be written as Q1. It is sigma multiplied by 4 pi r square. And if we calculate the charge on the second one, which is bigger sphere, that can be taken as Q2, which is sigma multiplied by this is 4 pi, the radius is 2r square. So this is 16 sigma pi r square. You can see this 4 times the charge of the first sphere. So if on first sphere we consider charge to be Q, on the second we can take it as 4Q. So on this charge is Q, here charge is 4Q. Now if the two are connected by a wire, we know the charge distribution will take place till their potential becomes equal. So we can write, after connecting wires, we use KQ1 final by R should be equals to KQ2 final by R, where Q1 final and Q2 final we consider the final charges on the two spheres. So here these two are. On simplifying, we are getting Q1 final is equals to Q2 final by 2. Here K and R gets cancelled out. And in parallel, we are also having, as the total charge of the system remains conserved, we also use Q1 final plus Q2 final must be equals to 5Q, that will be the total charge of the two sphere. If we substitute the value of Q1 final as Q2 final by 2, this is giving us 3Q2 final by 2 is equals to 5Q, which implies we are getting Q2 final, the final charge on the bigger sphere, to be this 10Q by 3. If we substitute the value of Q, which is sigma multiplied by 4 pi r square, this becomes 40 pi sigma r square by 3. This is the total charge on the bigger sphere after connecting the two when their potential becomes equal. So we can easily calculate the final charge density on bigger sphere is, this can be given as sigma final on the bigger sphere is Q2 final divided by its surface area, that is 4 pi 2r whole square, as 2r is its radius. So on substituting the values, you can see final charge is 40 pi sigma r square by 3 divided by the surface area, which is 16 pi r square. On simplifying, you can see here pi r square gets cancelled out, and we'll be getting it to be, this is 5 sigma by, you can cancel this by 8 to 5, so this can be written as 5 sigma by 6, that is the final surface charge density on the bigger sphere.